Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to the Palace at Crosby High School for another edition of Waterbury High School Basketball on Sky TV alongside Dave and Deb Thorald. I'm Chris Grace coming at you from the Brass City once again. We've got a good one for you tonight. The visitors from Waterbury Career Academy will take on the homestanding Bulldogs, and we should, like I said, have a very entertaining and exciting close matchup for you. The last time these two teams met, it took three overtimes before Crosby could withstand the Spartans on the road, 125-123. Crosby 11-4 on the season, coming off of an overtime win at Kennedy, and Career coming off their best win of the year, 75-73, in a thriller over Holy Cross. Spartans are 9-6, coached by Ronan O'Leary, and the Bulldogs, of course, coached by Nick Augelli, are 11-4 on the campaign. Just a few public address announcements, and then we'll have the starting lineups and the national anthem. Be ready to go here on Sky TV. So both teams seemingly finding their form at the most important part of the season. Coach O'Leary, speaking with him before the game, was very excited over their win over Holy Cross as they finally got over the hump in a inner-city game. See how that carries over tonight as they will take on the Bulldogs here at the Palace. This time I'm going to step back as we will honor our country with the playing of the national anthem. You're watching Waterbury High School Basketball on Sky TV, Channel 16. Just a tremendous rendition of the national anthem performed by a Crosby High student. Once again, we'd like to welcome you inside the Palace here at Augelli Court for tonight's Waterbury High School basketball matchup between the visiting Career Academy Spartans and the Crosby Bulldogs. I'm Chris Grace along with Dave and Deb Thorald. Now the starting lineups first for the visiting Spartans, coached by Ronan O'Leary in their second season. Marquand Watson, talented sophomore, along with another talented sophomore, Matt Torres. Chad McCoy, junior big man.
Number three, junior guard,
Kyron Petaway. And rounding out the Spartans lineup, junior point guard, Jaden Battle. Ronan O'Leary is the coach, 9-6 on the season. The young Spartans, so talented, been so close in so many games, finally won a close one as they took down Holy Cross last Friday night. And now for the starters for the Crosby Bulldogs. Elijah Carter will start at guard.
Number 22, sophomore guard, Kerwin Prince.
Kerwin Prince, this talented sophomore, will start at the two guard. Tariq Foggy, the junior, will start at forward.
Number four, senior point guard, co-captain.
Senior point guard, co-captain, Miguel Rivera. And the senior co-captain, center, Jeremiah Kendall. Of course, the Bulldogs, coached by the man whom this court is named, Nick Augelli. They are 11-4 coming off their overtime win over Kennedy last weekend. So the starters, once again, Kendall, Carter, Rivera, Prince, and Foggy. And for the Spartans, it'll be Watson, Battle, Torres, Petaway, and McCoy. Crosby wearing their home white uniforms, trimmed in royal blue with red trimming along the numbers. Spartans will be wearing their road black uniforms, trimmed in white with gold numerals, gold lettering across the front. Buckle up, this should be a fast-paced game. We mentioned last time they met, it was 125-123, three overtimes for the Bulldogs. Kendall and Watson will match up. Kendall with a, looks to be about a 2-inch height advantage over Marquand. And the tap is controlled to Foggy. Looking to run, taken away by Torres. Outlet pass for Jaden Battle. Hesitates on Rivera, hangs, throws up a runner that doesn't go. Watson on the offensive glass, no. Long rebound comes out for Petaway. Kyron thinks about it. Now he'll reset as Crosby lines up in man-to-man. Three for Torres. Side rim, no good. Long rebound comes down to Kerwin Prince, and he'll leave it for Kendall, who is going to bring the ball up the floor. Jeremiah spins, hangs, and he's fouled, and he'll go to the line. So 32 seconds in, we've got our first foul. I think they're going to get Petaway with the reach, and Jeremiah Kendall will go to the line. And the senior knocks down the first. So Kendall goes 2 for 2. The lead is 2 for the home team. Crosby settling back into a 2-3 look. See if they match up or if they stay in the zone. Does look like a traditional zone into Watson. Nice post move, can't finish. So Watson with two inside touches and he couldn't score either time. Now Rivera in transition, leaves it for Carter. Top of the key, three. Too strong. Rebound tipped and controlled by Jaden Battle, and the Spartans will look to get on the board. Jaden with the push. Kicks it out to Petaway, and they'll reset with Jaden Battle. Crosby stays in the 2-3. Now it looks more like a 2-1-2. Petaway's bump shooting the three, and he'll go to the line to shoot three. Kyron Petaway, the junior, will go to the line to shoot three. The foul was on Carter, his first, team's first. Too strong. Two more to come for the junior. Good atmosphere here inside the Palace tonight as the crowd's still filling in. So Kyron makes 1 of 3, and the lead is cut in half, 2-1. Career will start out man-to-man. Battle out guarding Rivera. Miguel leaves it for Prince. Looking to go baseline, hangs, can't hit. Rebound fought for and controlled by Watson. Gets it up to Battle. Jaden on the drive. Euro step, can't finish inside, and the rebound's pulled down for Foggy. Leaves it for Carter. Kendall on the wing is going to try one from the corner for three, and he knocks it home. So Jeremiah Kendall with 5 quick points, and the lead is 4-5-1 for the home team. Kendall extending his range this season, a much better outside shooter than in years past. Torres for Petaway, a long three, nothing but the bottom of the net. Kyron Petaway hits from downtown. He's got all 4 for career. Rivera in transition, throws up a runner, no. Long rebound. Tapped and controlled by Kendall. He fires it off of Watson's leg. They'll say that Kendall was still in bounds when he made the save. It'll stay with Crosby. Nice play by the senior. Struggling to get it in, they just do to Kendall. Leaves it for Rivera. Career staying man-to-man. Three from the wing, too strong. McCoy tips it, they'll say last touch by McCoy, it'll stay here. So career with opportunities, unable to take advantage early, and Crosby will maintain control of the ball with 5:36 to go in a one-point game. Inside to Kendall, double team down low. And a travel's gonna be called on Jeremiah. Nice job doubling up there by Pettaway to force the turnover. Battle will slow it down and walk it up. Torres. Crosby staying in this 2-3 zone. Back to Torres. Almost turns it over. Pettaway saves it just in front of the timeline. No look pass, and it's a bad one. Turned over. Foggy with the steal for Rivera. Finishes for two. Foggy with the assist. Rivera with his first 2 points. The lead is 3-7-4. Can't tell if it's a 2-on-2 or a 2-3 look. Watson back out to battle. As they try to spread the floor, Pettaway, nice ball fake. Down low for Watson, he hangs and he hits. Marquand Watson on the board and the lead is 1-7-6 as the talented sophomore gets his first deuce. Gonna go to Kendall. And another travel's gonna be called on Jeremiah. Second turnover on the co-captain. Back to career with 4:23 to play in the first. One possession game, 7-6. Battle out to Pettaway. Looking to go inside to McCoy. It's deflected by Kendall. On the steal, Carter off the window gets the roll. Nice play by Kerwin Prince. Set up Carter and he spun it up and in. Watson will try a corner three and he knocks it home. Marquand from downtown. All tied up at 9 apiece. Watson with 5 points to lead the way for the Spartans. Carter, too strong. And a foul's gonna be called on the rebound. See who they get here. They're gonna keep it here. They're gonna call the foul on McCoy. Boy, I thought it was the other way. No, they're not. They're gonna get Prince. Okay, that makes more sense. So they're gonna call Prince for going around the back of McCoy. That'll be the first on the talented sophomore. Second team foul. Now they're gonna extend and look to trap in half court. Down for McCoy, back out to battle, and Pettaway from the wing for three, too strong, long rebound. Torres saves it, back to Pettaway. For Torres in the corner, for three, rattles around and out. Pettaway looked for the board, couldn't get there though. Foggy with the rebound for Crosby. Kendall looking to push it. Carter will fire from the corner, nothing but the bottom of the net. Eli Carter gives the Bulldogs back the lead, 12-9. Battle deals with the pressure down low for McCoy and he finishes strong off the glass. Chad McCoy with his first two. 1 point game, 12-11. Carter on the hesitation, throws up a runner out of control and the rebound for McCoy. Stripped, but it'll stay with the Spartans. Last touch by Kendall. We're gonna see our first subs as Ivan Craig checks in, as does Arante Williams, replacing Carter and Prince. 2:33 to go in the first. Crosby up front. Torres will get a breather as Edwards checks in. So they're extending this 2-3 into a trapping half-court zone. dealt with. McCoy strong, a lot of contact, but they'll say clean play by Craig. In transition, Foggy back to Craig. He'll fire, rattles around and out. Petaway with the rebound, up for Battle. Quick in transition, and they're going to call a charge. Boy, tough call. Say Rivera got there in time. And they're going to get Battle with the offensive foul. Boy, that could have gone either way. It's going to be Battle charged with the offensive foul, his first, second team foul. Foggy on the screen, lays it up, no good. Tip for Kendall doesn't go, it goes back to Foggy. And a jump ball will be called. Possession arrow will favor the visitors. So Spartans had a few chances there. Racine will check in, replacing McCoy. Langston Racine, another sophomore, very talented. So Battle will walk it up, is now the look to trap all the way at the timeline. Again, Doctor in for the first time. That's him right there with the basketball for Racine. Hangs off the window, no, but the follow-up is there for Watson. And Career takes the lead, 13-12. Watson with 7 points to lead the way for the Spartans. Rivera pulls up, nothing but the bottom of the net. Can't give him any space, he'll make you pay. Miguel Rivera with 5 points. Battle. Down for Watson, what a feed. Marquand with 9. All tied up at 15. Kendall from 2 feet behind the line, too strong. Rebound, still loose, last touched by Foggy. He'll go back over to the Spartans with 66 seconds to play in the first. Williams will pick up Battle. Full court, now they'll look to trap. Racine with the extra pass for Doctor, and he gets it. For Career, and the Spartans take the lead. So Crosby right now, their pressure not paying dividends. It's resulting in easy layups for the Spartans. 45 to play in the first. Kendall on the spin, and he's bumped. He'll go to the line, see who they get on the foul. They're gonna get Doctor with the foul, his first, team's third. Kendall will go to the line where he's 2 for 2 so far. Kendall's really the only guy that played big time minutes for Crosby last year. Pretty amazing if you think about it that they're 11-4 with so little experience. Paris Brinkley, he had some experience last year. He checks in replacing Rivera. And
number 32, Marquise Days.
Marquise Days will check in, giving Foggy a blow. Kendall rattles it home, and we're all tied up. So Kendall 4 for 4 from the line. He'll be replaced by Nosek Binaware. Career with 40 seconds left, taking their time here, bringing it up, and they could hold for the last shot if they so choose. Crosby staying with the 2-3. Edwards from the wing, short. Rebound tipped, last touch by Crosby with 27.2. It'll stay with the Spartans in a tie ball game. Get it to Watson with 25 on the game clock. Back for Jaden Battle now. Leaves it for Marquand Watson. Skip pass to Edwards. Battle with 15 on the drive. Hangs and he scores. Jaden Battle with great body control. 8 seconds left in the first. Craig with 3. I don't think he knows it. Igbinoware has to fire, and he scores. And he knocks it home over Watson. It counts. Nosek Igbinoware with a buzzer beater, and we'll head to the second. Crosby leads this one 20-19. We got a good one for you. Don't go anywhere. After one, Crosby 20, Career Academy 19 on your home for Waterbury High School basketball. Sky TV, Channel 16. Welcome back to the Palace alongside Dave and Deb Thorold. I'm Chris Grace here on Sky TV. Bulldogs will start with the ball with a one-point lead thanks to the buzzer-beater three hit by Nosa Kpinawari over the top of the 6'3 Marquand Watson. It's 20-19. Starters back in for the Bulldogs. Carter leaves it for Rivera. Inside to Kendall, working on Watson. Spins with the right, and he scores. Nice post move there for Jeremiah, and the lead is three. Doctor leaves it for Battle. Back to Edwards. Battle will try one from the wing. That's off the window and in. Well, the glass is there for a reason, and Jaden takes advantage. Ties it up at 22. Career staying man-to-man. Carter working into the corner for Kendall. Jeremiah will leave it for Carter with 7 minutes on the game clock. Back to Kendall, nearly lost it. Now he finds it. Crossover, spin move, he hangs, can't hit, but he'll go to the line for two more. So a broken play results in more free throws for the senior co-captain. Watson will be charged with his first, team's fourth. Kendall 4-for-4 from the stripe. Torres will check in for Racine. So Kendall, a perfect 6-for-6 from the line, and the lead is two, 24-22. Really improved his shooting stroke this season. Crosby staying in the 2-3. Torres, down low for Doctor. Nice feed for Watson, and he can't finish. Nice pass by Doctor, but Marquand couldn't get it to go from point blank. Carter in transition, drops it off, and Prince with his first two. Carter with the assist, the lead is four. Torres gets the high ball screen from Watson and leaves it for Jaden Battle. Over to Edwards on the wing. The lone senior on this roster. Now Torres will fire, rattles it home. Matt Torres shows off his stroke and the lead is cut to one, 26-25. Some big time shooting on display here in the first half. Rivera with the step back, rattles around and out, rebound for Battle. Jaden on the push, gets all the way to the cup, can't hit it though. Doctor tipped it but couldn't control the board. Now Kendall in transition, he's gonna try one, short. Rebound for Watson. Nowhere to go. Marquand's going to bring it up himself. 26-25. Edwards back out to Watson. Now he'll leave it for Battle with 5:27 on the game clock. Torres looking to go baseline. Throws up a little runner, and it's an air ball, and it comes down for Prince for Crosby. Leaves it for Carter. Career staying man-to-man. Rivera, wide open look. Nothing but the bottom of the net. Miguel Rivera hits his second three ball, and the lead is four, 29-25. Can't give him that much space. Battle leaves it for Edwards. Edwards will try one. Rattles around and out. Rebound controlled by Watson to Torres for three. Bounces off the top of the backboard out to Rivera, and he's going to look to run. Miguel in transition, denied by Torres. Rebound tracked down, though, and Carter will try from three, too strong. Rebound for Prince, and a foul is going to be called. Count the basket. Wow, that's a tough call. They're going to get Watson with the foul. Looks like he was straight up. Prince will have a chance for the three-point play. Second on Marquand, they can't afford to lose him, and a timeout's going to be taken by Coach O'Leary with 4:25 to play in the first half. Crosby with their biggest lead, 31-25. watching Waterbury High School basketball on Sky TV Channel 16. .425 to play in the first half. Crosby holding their biggest lead. Sophomore Prince hit the line, looking to complete the three-point play the old-fashioned way. After Marquand Watson picked up his second foul, he was replaced by McCoy during the timeout. And Prince completes the three-point play. The lead is 7. Officials timeout for a wet spot back there. So Edwards battle. Petaway, McCoy, and Torres, the 5 on the floor for the Spartans. Carter Rivera, Kendall Prince, and Foggy, the starting 5, are the 5 on the floor for Coach Augelli's men. Torres lost it on the perimeter, and they'll reset. So far, Crosby stayed in the 2-3 the entire game. Taken away by Kendall. 3-on-1. Rivera for Kendall. Nice steal by Torres. Matt in transition. Gets all the way. A block. Count the basket. Matt Torres with a chance to cut into the margin at the free throw line. A nice play with the steal. He gets all the way to the basket. The sophomore with a chance at the three-point play. Foggy hit with the foul. Just the third team foul and the first on Foggy. Craig will check back in, replacing Prince. Torres swishes home the free throw and the lead is back to 4. 32-28. Career looking to press now. Craig for Rivera, nearly taken away by Battle. Craig from the wing. Ivan Craig hits his first three ball and the lead is 7, 35-28. Both teams lethal from the outside. Battle looking to solve this zone. Pulls up from just inside the line and it's partially deflected back over to Crosby. Rivera in transition leaves it for Craig. He'll try another one. This one's no good. Edwards leaves it for Jaden Battle. Petaway, wide open look from the corner. Nothing but the bottom of the net. Kyron Petaway, his second three ball, and the lead's back to 4. Rivera leaves it for Foggy, and he lays it up and in. Easy hoop in transition for Foggy. Nice feed from Rivera. 37-31. Battle pulls up. Pure. Jaden Battle with a long 2. Boy, what a fun game we've got for you here tonight. Looking to trap Carter, and a reach-in's going to be called on Petaway. 2 on Kyron. Langston Racine will check in to replace Petaway, I would imagine. Sixth team foul on the Spartans. I think that's 2 on Petaway. It is. 2:18 to go, 37-33. They'll get it into Carter. Craig leaves it for Foggy as they look to post up Kendall. Taken away. Racine got a piece of it. Torres comes away with it, and a bump is going to be called. I believe they're going to get Foggy for his second, team's 4th. Kerwin Prince will replace Foggy. Ronte Williams checks back in for Carter. Marquand Watson will replace Edwards for the Spartans. 2:03 left to go in an entertaining first half. Rivaling the first time these teams met, 125-123 in triple overtime. All the way in the backcourt, Battle tracks it down with Rivera in his pocket. Deflected and stolen away. Knocked back by Battle, and now it's over with Rivera. He'll fire. Miguel Rivera hits his third first half three, and the lead is back to seven. Battle, traveling violation, one step too many. Looked like a good Euro step there. The trail official called him for steps. Can't say I agree with that one. 40-33, 1:44 to go. Career showing 2-2-1 full court pressure, reminiscent of the old school Jim Calhoun Husky, UConn Husky teams. Corner three, this one's short. Rebound, last touch by Kendall. It'll go back to the Spartans with 91 seconds to play in the first half. Looks like they're setting up a half-court trap here. 1-2-2, and it is. They are going to trap. He's got to get it over the timeline quickly. Almost a 10-second violation. Racine stripped. And for the second time today, Kendall saves it off the legs of an unaware Spartan player. This time it was McCoy who wasn't ready for it. And Kendall saves the possession for Crosby. 40-33. Spartans again showing 2-2-1, full court pressure. We approach the final minute of the first half. Rivera and Kendall exchanging passes. They break the press. Looking for Prince, he can't hit, gets his own miss. Second chance, no. Third chance, he's stripped. Racine with the block. Langston looking to run for Battle. 55 on the clock, switches it to Watson. Torres, corner three, and he hits. 40-36, Matt Torres with another three-pointer. The lead is trimmed to four. Kendall throws one up short. It's a man down there on the block, though. Gets another rebound. He puts it up and in. 42-36. 30 seconds left. Battle, a human press break, and he's fouled on the perimeter. I think they're going to get Rivera with the reach in. Only the fifth team foul on the Bulldogs, so it'll stay with the Spartans with 26.2 to play in the first half. First on Miguel, 15 foul. Career picking up man-to-man now for the first time. Into the backcourt they go with Battle, and they'll look to set up a half-court trap. He's got to hurry up and get it across the timeline, though. And he is trapped on the step-through. Gets to Racine. Kick ball off of Kendall with 12.6. No call on the kick ball. Agree with Coach O'Leary. Doesn't make a difference. It wouldn't change anything, but should have been a kick ball. Igbinoare checks back in, replacing Kendall. 12 seconds left in the first half. Watson, another kick ball goes by the wayside. In transition, Rivera with four. For Craig with two, Rivera will fire. This one's short. The buzzer sounds, and that'll be the end of the first half. So a back and forth first half, and it finishes out with Crosby holding a 42-36 lead at the break. We'll be back in just a bit for the second half from the Palace. After two quarters, the Bulldogs lead the Spartans by six. Your home for Waterbury High School basketball, Sky TV, Channel 16. Welcome back to the Crosby Palace on the campus of Crosby High School, home of the Bulldogs. Right now, the Bulldogs are winning an inter-city matchup 42-36 over the visitors. The upstart program in the Brass City, Waterbury Career Academy. It's 42-36 as we're getting ready to start half number two, along with Deb Thorault and Dave Thorault. I'm Chris Grace. You're home for Waterbury High School basketball, Sky TV. Channel 16. Bulldogs led by one after one. They've stretched it to six at the break, but there is a lot left in this one. The last time these two teams met, it took three overtimes before Crosby could hold on for the 125-123 win. So well played first half, both teams, great shooting from the outside. The difference probably, I would say, is the second chance buckets for the Bulldogs right now. Both teams having opportunities on the offensive glass, but Crosby more efficient with their putback so far than career. Petaway battle, McCoy, Watson and Torres, Carter, Foggy, Prince, Rivera, and Kendall for the Bulldogs. Crosby again settling into a 2-3 half-court zone. Spartans get it to Petaway. Step back three, top of the key, and he hits. Petaway with his third three ball, and the lead is trimmed to three, 42-39. Carter in transition. Back out for Foggy, looking to drive. Out of control, and he hits. Looked like Ray Allen in the Big East title game there with the hanging runner. The lead is back to five, 44-39. Marquand Watson will try one. Off the window, no. McCoy with the rebound. He's tied up, and they're going to call a jump ball. Possession arrow will favor the Bulldogs. Kendall, guarded by Watson with two fouls. Gets it to Foggy on the drive. Kick out to Kendall, wide open three. Jeremiah Kendall. Boy, does his stroke look good tonight. 47-39, Kendall the leading scorer. Battle. They're gonna get a block, I believe. See, no call was made. We're going to get Carter on the call. His second team's first. Jaden Battle will go to the line. So Jaden swishes home two freebies, and the lead is back to where it stood at halftime. 1-2-2 full court pressure. Dealt with by the Bulldogs. Foggy pulls up and he hits. Nice mid-range from Tariq Foggy, and the lead is back to 8, 49-41. Torres on the curl. Pulls up on Rivera and he hits. Nice mid-range from Torres. In transition now. Rivera flying through. Almost lost it, but he gets it to Kendall. Leaves it for Rivera. Carter swings it to Foggy. Side rim no good, but the long rebound goes off the hands of Watson. Right to Prince. There's a missed opportunity for the Spartans. Prince with the two. Torres, transition three. Too strong. Rebound for Prince. Crosby can take their biggest lead of the night on this possession. To the corner. Kendall will try another one. This one short, long rebound. Goes to Watson. Marquand jumps through and Kendall strips him. But it'll stay here. Inbounded back to Jaden Battle. Swing pass for Petaway. This time he up fakes, pulls up from 15 and it's short. Right to Prince. Rivera looking to run for Kendall. Looked like he got away with steps there. Timeout career. Full timeout. 5:19 to go in the third. Crosby with their biggest lead, 53-43. We'll take a timeout. Your home for Waterbury High School basketball, Sky TV, Channel 16. Welcome back to the Palace alongside Deb Thorault and Dave Thorault. Chris Grace from the home of the Bulldogs. And right now the Bulldogs enjoying their biggest lead of the night, 53-43. Get it inside to Watson, deep, can't finish. Kendall with the rebound. Now he's going to look to run. Leaves it for Rivera. On the drive. Goes right to Kendall after.
Kendall. Assist Foggy.
After Foggy lost the handle and it just like a magnet went right to Jeremiah and he lays it up and in. 55-43. Petaway launches another air ball. Rebound pulled down by Prince. Danger time now for the Spartans. Prince gives it up. Battle hangs and he lays it up and in. That's a big sequence there. Battle brings it back to a 10-point game and they'll try to trap in full court. The pressure has not been too successful yet though. Prince gets all the way to the bucket for two. Strong drive for the sophomore. Stretches it back out to 12, 57, 45. Petaway turns it over. Foggy with the steal. Three on two. Leaves it for Carter. Off the window and in.
Assist Tyree Foggy.
59-45. Battle pulls up from the free throw line. Jaden Battle willing his team on. Kendall back to Foggy, and he loses it out of bounds. Edwards and Racine will come in for McCoy and or Watson, excuse me, and Petaway. Starting five remains in the game for Crosby as Coach Ogilic cuts down his rotation here in the second half. Battle leaves it for Torres. Back to Battle. Torres from the wing, rises, fires all over it, but he couldn't get the bounce. Rebound for Foggy. Leaves it for the diminutive point guard. Back to Foggy from the wing. The crowd will tell you that that one went down and the lead is 15 points. Racine. Torres drops it off for McCoy and he finishes. Nice pick and roll that time. Assist to Torres, 62-49. Trying to trap Carter and he deals with it, drops it down low, but a reach-in's gonna be called before Foggy could put it up. It's the first team foul of the second half against the Spartans. Didn't see who they called it on. Looks like they're gonna get McCoy with his first. Get it into Kendall, working on McCoy. Nice up and under move. Just a man among boys out there tonight for Jeremiah Kendall. Lead is 15. Torres back for Battle. Pulls up from NBA range and he hammers one. Jaden Battle with the NBA three-pointer. Jaden having a great third quarter. Steals it, saves it for Edwards. Back to Battle, he'll try another one. Rattles around and out. Long rebound, last touch by Crosby. So Battle putting his team on his 5'8" shoulders, leading the way. Without him, this would be a big time blowout, but as it stands, it's just a 12 point game. Love the way Jaden Battle plays. Racine to take it out with 2:08 on the clock and try this one again. McCoy and Kendall, apparently a little too much posturing for the official. He'll inbound to Jaden Battle with 2:05 on the clock. Crosby leads 64-52. Battle gets the high ball screen, works it over for Torres. Outside, Racine. Into the corner for Edwards, back out to Matt Torres. Battle with the drive, stripped. Prince leaves it for Kendall. A lot of contact, no call either way. Prince with the offensive rebound. Over the back's gonna be called on Prince. Back over to the Spartans. Huge for career if they can cut this to single digits before the fourth quarter. Crosby will make their first change of the second half. Actually, second change as Ronte Williams and Ivan Craig come in for Rivera and Prince. Williams nearly with the steal. Career maintains control with 1:20 left in the third. Battle from the wing, too strong. Rebound for Craig. Leaves it to Carter. Eli Carter will run the point. Jump stop, he traveled with the basketball.
No basket, travel violation, Crosby.
Pivot foot slid that time. He'll go back over to the Spartans. Rivera will replace Carter. Watson will replace Edwards for career. 65 seconds to play in the third quarter. Crosby led by 6 at halftime. They've doubled that here in the third. Torres for 3. Nothing but the bottom of the net. Torres with his third 3 ball and the lead is down to 9. Again, going full court, 2-2-1. Again, Crosby clinically breaking the pressure. Battle's gonna be hit with the reach in though. Second on Jaden, second team foul, 44.1 to go in the third.
And
Munoz checks in for the first time for Crosby, replacing Foggy. Rivera wide open three. This time he misses. Watson with the rebound. Jaden looking to push. A travel's going to be called in transition. Boy, I don't know about that. That's a tough call. 64-55. Crosby can hold for the last shot. Rivera saves a turnover there back for Munoz. To the corner with Craig with 25 on the game clock. Trapped. Keeps it alive. Ronte Williams fires it off of McCoy. And it'll stay with the Bulldogs with 17.4 on the clock. They get it into Rivera, and he just keeps it in. 12 left. Rivera's gonna isolate and hold for one. Looking to go on battle with five. And a 5 second call. I think that's the right call. Battle closely guarded for 5 seconds. And Career will get the last shot here with 3.8. Watson to take it out, trailing by nine. Gets it into Torres. With one and he's stripped. And that's good if it goes. But it doesn't. So we played three quarters, and the home team, the Crosby Bulldogs, leading the visitors from Career Academy 64-55. We'll be right back for the fourth quarter from the Palace. You're watching Waterbury High School basketball on your home for Brass City High School hoops, Sky TV. Welcome back to the Palace. Just getting ready to start the fourth quarter, along with Dave Thorall, Chris Grace. Spartans will inbound, trailing by nine. Petaway leaves it for Battle. Starting five on the floor for both teams. Battle with the hesitation drives and he's stripped. Watson comes away with the loose ball and Marquand lays it up and in the lead, trimmed to seven, 64-57. Again showing full court pressure. Again it's dealt with. Foggy with the strong drive over McCoy. 66-57. I don't know if the pressure is the right move against this Crosby team. On the free throw line, Torres for three. A lot of contact, rebound comes out to Petaway. Back to Kyron from the wing, too strong. And an over the back is going to be called. It's going to stay here as Prince is going to be hit with the foul. I believe that's his fourth. Is it just his third?
Second foul, team turnover.
Third team foul on the Bulldogs. Off the inbounds, Torres from the corner rattles around and out. Every shot he throws up looks like it's going down. Kendall in transition. Strong drive and he scores. Leads back to double figures, 68-57. Just no answer for Kendall tonight. Watson with the high ball screen. Go back to Battle. Now Torres looking to throw it inside. It's taken away by who else? Kendall. Now he's going to run the point. Ahead of steam, he spins out of control off the window and he hits. What a move by Kendall. 70-57. Battle looks to answer for Watson. Down low to McCoy and Chad finishes off the glass. Nice offensive set there. Watson with the helper. Again, looking to press. Again, easily dealt with by Rivera. Leaves it for Kendall. To the corner, Foggy. Side rim, long rebound to Torres. 3-on-2. Matt fouled off the window, no, but he'll go to the line for two. See who they get here. I think it's going to be Rivera. Will be on Rivera, his second, team's fifth. Matt Torres will go to the stripe to shoot two. Matt's 2-for-2 from the line tonight. Ivan Craig checks in, replacing Foggy in the lineup. One more for Torres, and he can't get either one. So the lead will stay at 11. Two big free throws there go by the wayside. Rivera will pull up in transition. No good. Long rebound. He can't finish for Carter from inside. And Battle is bumped 70 feet away by Prince, and that'll be another foul. Third on Prince, 15 foul. Rontae Williams checks in, replacing Miguel Rivera with 5:54 to go. 11-point game. Headway for Watson, back to Kyron. Top of the key with Jaden Battle, looking to drive. Hangs, he's fouled, and he'll go to the stripe. Smart take there from Jaden. They're going to get Prince with his fourth foul. Three of which have come in the last couple minutes. 16 fouls, so Prince now with four, and the Bulldogs are one foul away from being in, or excuse me, the Spartans are one foul away from being in the bonus. Days will come in for Prince. Battle, who's hit three in a row at the line, can make it a single-digit game here if he hits this one. And curse of the commentator. Long rebound, though, for McCoy. Finds Watson. He's trapped. Last touched by Days. It'll stay here. 70-60. Career staying within striking distance. Get it into Watson. Back for Battle. Jaden on the drive, can't hit as he was falling to the ground. Rebound to Kendall. Carter in transition. Nice ball fake, wide open look. Can't hit it. Outlet pass for Torres. Matt scores off the window with Kendall in his shadow. It leads down to 8. Again, they'll press full court. Watson can't get his hand on it. Wide open 3 and air ball. Long rebound for Days, though. He goes up. Travel, I think. Traveling violation, that's the right call. Back to career. It's an 8-point game, 70-62. Timeout taken by Coach Augelli with 4:59 to go in the fourth quarter. Bulldogs still lead, but it's only by 8 on your home for Waterbury High School basketball. Sky TV, Channel 16. .459 to go in a exciting basketball game here at the Palace. The young upstart Spartans from Career Academy have cut the lead to 8 after trailing by as many as 15 here in the second half. Battle for Petaway, 3. And he hits, and it's a 5-point game, and Coach O'Leary inspiring his team now. 70-65. Carter breaks the pressure, gets it all the way inside, and he's rejected. Loose ball. McCoy saves it, though, right to Carter. Golden opportunity goes by the wayside for the Spartans. Kendall with some steam pulls up and he hits. It's a big play there by the Bulldogs. In transition now. Torres trapped and he skips one over to Petaway with 4:17. Watson corner three, pure. 72-68, here we go. An outlet pass. Inside they get it to Kendall and he scores. They are just slicing this pressure like it's hot butter tonight, and I'll tell you what, might have to go away from that. 74-68. Torres for Battle. Petaway will try another one. This time it's short, rebound picked up by Ivan Craig. Kendall leaves it for Williams. Back out to Jeremiah with 3:27. He's gonna look to drive on Watson. Spins, hangs, this time he doesn't get it to go. Last touch, they'll say. They're gonna say that was last touch by Watson. Boy, that's a tough call. Edwards checks in for McCoy. I don't think the official was in position there. Looked for sure like that was last touched on the interior by the Bulldogs. Get it into Prince, top of the key three, wide open look. Jeremiah Kendall, he's been the difference, and just like that, it's a 9-point game. What a difference a call makes. Battle for Torres from the wing, too strong. Watson gets a piece of it, and it goes back out to Petaway. Battle, and Watson's still on the ground. They're gonna stop the action as Marquand slow to get up. Still hurting down there. And boy, you hate to see this. I didn't see what happened, but Marquand, who is so talented. And now he's up. It looks like he was just shaking up. The floor's a little wet now. It's good to see. I don't want to see anything happen to him. 2:56 to go. Career showing their grit and determination, but unable to contain Kendall tonight. And he has been the sole difference maker. They've done a nice job on Rivera, but Kendall has just been too much inside and outside. At 49 in the first meeting, and Venture guessed that he's over 30 tonight. Still time for a career, but they're running out of lifelines. Torres will take it out as McCoy replaces Watson. He tries to shake loose the cobwebs. Goes into Chad McCoy, back for Jaden Battle with 2:55 on the clock. Torres uses the ball fake, pulls up, throws up a little leaner, and he hits. Boy, Matt Torres showing off his all-around game tonight. 77-70. Again, they go 2-2-1. And this time it results in a loose ball, but it's scooped up by who else but Kendall. For Rivera, and he'll smartly pull it back out with 2:33. Still eat up some clock. Spartans have to extend, and with only two fouls committed, they're gonna have to force some turnovers here because they're a long way from forcing free throws. Kendall on the drive. Can't get the roll. Rebound taken away by Kendall, and he scores. Looked like Edwards and McCoy collided there, and Chad is slow to get up. He's hobbling down the floor. Torres in transition pulls up, and he hits. 79-72. Rivera finds Craig, who's been a great outlet in the second half. Back to Carter with 1:53. Career has to extend now, try to extend this game. Close to a five call again. Prince looking to drive, and he can't get the roll. Rebound for Torres. Battle in transition. Off the leg of Battle and out of bounds. Boy, every time Career has a chance to get it really close. Haven't gotten the bounce. 1:32 to play. Crosby with the ball, leading by 7. Go across to Rivera. Kendall leaves it for Craig. Back to Carter. I don't know why he took the shot. Didn't need it. Rebound for Watson. Torres in transition. Pulls up from 3, and he doesn't get the bounce. Needed that. Now they've got a foul. Timeout taken by Crosby. I have a funny feeling Coach Augelli's going to let Carter know that he wasn't too pleased with that shot. Just a guess. With 1:09 to go, Bulldogs with the basketball and a 7-point lead. Your home for Waterbury High School basketball, Sky TV, Channel 16. So just 69 seconds remain, and although the young Spartans in just their second season of a varsity team have been right there along the way, they've been unable to cut into this lead late as it has stayed between 10 points and about 7 or 8. Right now it's at 7. Looking to trap Rivera, and he'll call a timeout. So the trap results in a timeout, but again, the Bulldogs will have the basketball. Smart timeout by Rivera. Bulldogs will be on the road against Sacred Heart before hosting Holy Cross a week from yesterday. They've got 4 more games left in the regular season. They hold on to win this one, they'll improve to 12-4, which when you think about it, for a team that's basically got one guy returning as a starter, amazing coaching job by the veteran coach, Nick Augelli. Only 2 team fouls committed by the Spartans, so they're going to force Crosby to the line. They're going to have to start fouling fast and frequently. First, they got to get it in, and they do so to Kendall. Leaves to Rivera. He'll shoot a 3. Again, they don't need the shot. Offensive rebound and a block by Watson. I have no idea why they're shooting the basketball. Here comes Petaway in transition. It's deflected out of bounds. We'll stay with the Spartans. Boy, oh boy. No shot clock, and you're up by 7. You don't need to shoot. We see it all the time. It boggles the mind. Petaway for 3. Short, long rebound. Kyron couldn't track it down. And the Bulldogs can just about put this one away. Kendall will finish. Clock still running. It's a 9-point game. 33 seconds left. Spartans need to hurry. Battle leaves it for Petaway. Corner, Torres. They got to hustle here. Taking way too much time. Watson. Deflects out of bounds with 22.7, but right there you're seeing the inexperience from the Spartans here down the stretch. Off the inbounds, Watson's 3 is blocked, and that should just about do it. Get it to Rivera, he'll pull it back out. They're going to foul, but just the 3rd team foul as the crowd starts to stream out here of the Palace. And another close game, but it's going to be another disappointing loss for Coach O'Leary and another impressive win for Coach Augelli. Still need to foul 4 more times with 15 seconds left. They'll get it in, and they will foul again. Team foul number 4. taken away, but unable to score in transition. Another foul. Prince unhappy with the grab from Edwards, but I don't think there was any malicious intent there. Still just the fifth team foul. So it'll be side out of bounds for the Bulldogs with 5.4. On the clock. They get it into Rivera, and he'll just dribble it out. The final 3 seconds, and that's going to do it. So the Bulldogs will win this one to improve to 12-4. Spartans drop another tough one to fall to 9-7. It was a fun game tonight. Didn't quite rival the one earlier in the season, but how could you? It's going to do it for us tonight from the Palace. For Dave and Deb Thoreau, I'm Chris Grace. Crosby wins this one by 9. You've been watching Waterbury High School basketball on your home for Waterbury High School Hoops, Sky TV, Channel 16. Until next time, so long, everybody.